So here we go. So we got the number of tickets. And then we have fee for the cost. You see, we got 3, 4, 5, and 6. 3 was how much? 4? $5? And then we $33. So, what should our rule be? It has to be written in an equation. So we know it goes up $5.50, right? So what should we put as the equation or the rule, the equation that is the rule for this tax? Not times n, but times. So it should be $5.50 times C. And the other rule can be, and I think that's what you, I think it sounded like you were trying to combine the two. So it could be, right, either or. So you could write it like this. This would be the true. You will put C equals the cost of the ticket, okay, equals $5.50 times E. But just to make a clean break, I went to number 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Alright, and then it's going to be 33, 34, 35, 36, and 37. So, what do we think the rule is? What do we think the rule is? And we can have division, subtraction, or division. Okay, give me an equation, please. Yes. Okay, you ready? Yeah. So what does it look like? Let's observe the pattern. That's the first thing that we should do. So what does it look like with the pattern? What do we see? Okay, so we can say that the order of operation is X. Okay, what else do we see? X, 1, and then 33. 2, and then 34. 3, and then 35. 4, and then 36. 5, and then 37. What's the next? The back. What's next? I mean, not what's next, I'm sorry. But what do you see based on what I see? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 going across, 33, 34, 35, 36, 37 going down at the bottom. You said adding 1? Okay. I'm going to get you all mechanical chemicals in a minute because you're always very distracted. You said add 1. Is that what happens? 1 plus 1 equals 33?
No.
Adding 32. Okay, so we would say, how would we put that in the equation, Moses? So we know Y is the answer, right? So we could put Y equals 32.
Come on.
M equals. Did you say 5332? What? No, it's just get off that last problem. That was 32. Last problem. What number? You said it right the first time. Uh-huh. There you go. Now, look at number 7. While I'm doing number 7, I want you to do number 7. And then I want you to tell me how to do it. So your table, you have A and B variables, correct? Read them across. 0, 3. Come on, my eyes are bad. And then what's next?
14.
Is it 14 or 12?
12.
Okay, give me the bottom numbers.
14.
Next. So, what do you need? You need A,
B, and order of operations.
Right, or order of operations. Look at the pattern. Tell me what you see. Tell me what you see, Daviana.
I noticed that A is
somebody wants to disagree. Okay, Marquise, what do you notice? You said it's adding 3. So be careful, because A is 0. The output is 14. So 0 plus 3 equals 14. You understand what I'm saying now? So look at it very carefully. You notice up here, you probably notice here is a pattern of multiple of 3, right? Yeah, but what does this mean down here? So if you put 3 in and you get 17 out. What does that mean? Okay, you say add 14. You think that's the rule?
Yes.
Okay, raise your hand if you agree with Andrew. Okay, hands down. Okay, so give me the equation. Yeah, I got you. So you'll do your table. Bottom. at the top, two at the bottom, 18 at the top, three at the bottom, 24 at the top, and four at the bottom. Let's look for pattern. Wait a minute. Show me the pattern. Okay, well, how would you write these questions? It should really be Y equals X divided by 6. Cross out the top. Very good. Very good. Okay, let's try number 9. Face on y'all. Who wants to do number 9? Write it below the 9. Okay, hit the little dot, not that one, the one in the middle. Yep, there you go. Pin at the bottom back. Up, right there. Go ahead, you good. All the way. U and then V at the bottom. You want to draw a line across. Come on, Andrew. Alright. So the first set of numbers is 0 and then 25. You want to draw a line on the other side?
V.
Okay. Next set, 124. Next set, 2, 23. Next set, 3, and it's blank. 3 at the top, and then the next set, draw another line, is 4. Excuse me. So you gotta figure out what is the 3 and 4. So you guys can go ahead and do that. Wait a minute. Yeah, and then you gotta tell me the rules. So look at the pattern. Jayla, you see a pattern? What do you say? Okay, you say subtract. All right, so what would that mean for 22? I'm sorry, for 3 and 4. What goes underneath 3 and 4? Okay, 22 goes under 3. And what's next? 21 would go under 4. Okay. Now, what would be the rule? Not you. You. All right, thank you. Okay, so we have 10. Zero, zero. What's next? some practice. And you will have homework on this tonight. Yes, sir.
I tell me what career. Yeah. I noticed this talking, we back to that. No. work and I'm cool.
Do the work.